across the finish line. What did you think?
I was so shocked. I went into the race completely ready for a fast race.
Yeah.
I just tried my best to focus on myself, you know, and the things that my coach taught me, and the race went great.
All those girls, like four or five of you, just clawing it out to get to the finish line. Nobody wanted to lose that race. What do you think pulled it out for you?
Honestly, me being mentally tough, me knowing that I'm in a race with a bunch of competitive girls, and that it was going to come down to who had the best start, who had the best finish, and yeah.
Do you feel like that was the best execution of a race you've ever had?
I feel like I couldn't execute it any better. I went into the race mentally tough, and I had advice from my coach. I was just confident. I went into the race really calm, you know, not nervous, just really calm. And
you know, you race those girls in that great 60-meter indoors at New Balance Indoor at the Armory. Did you feel like you learned anything from that experience and that you were able to take it away into your second national championship?
Yes, for sure. That was my first race, like my first competitive race. And like I was just at the utmost blessed to be inside of a race with phenomenal girls. And I just knew that their speed was going to push me, and it did.
When Tia Jones, let's say, was running 13-14 in the prelims, do you pay attention to any of that, or you just focus on what you're doing?
I always try to watch all the rounds, all of the heats and whatnot, just because I just want to. I'm very interested in the event. I wasn't really shocked by it, because I know she's a phenomenal competitor. I just try to focus on myself for the most part, and just knew that it was going to be a race when we were together.
What was the feeling like in the blocks? Is everyone, you know, all these girls that are potential champions get in the blocks together? What was going through your heart and your mind and everything?
Oh my gosh. I was just thinking about staying down, positioning my legs and my fingers right, not having my fingers on the white line, of course. and just making sure that I had a fast start.
When you go back to earlier in the spring, you ran 13.09 wind aid. Wasn't that a mile sack? Or was it some big meet? I forgot.
I was at Florida Relays.
Texas Relays. Was that out-of-state experience and running that fast? Do you think that kind of helped you a little bit too? I mean, you knew you could run under 13.10, and you knew you could run in a major meet, you know, sort of out of your comfort zone, out of the Northeast. Do you feel like that helped a little bit coming in today in retrospect?
Most definitely. It really did bring my confidence to a high, because prior to that 13.09, I had only ran a 13.7. So it was a huge jump for me, and it's letting me know that I'm working very hard and that my hard work is turning out. And it was a great experience. I would do it again next year. I can't wait.
Is that national record sort of like becoming a little bit like you can almost taste it?
Hopefully. I'm going to be in Clovis next week in California, so hopefully I can get it there. I can't wait.
You got two more years to get it,
I
right?
do, yeah.
Wow. All right. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.